A lot of rappers still, it seems like, want to be Tupac. They want to have his popularity. They want people to love them like they everyone loves him. But why do you think no one's succeeding?
Well, because this is what they fail to realize about Tupac. In order for them to be Tupac, they would have to die before they peaked. Like, before they peaked, they would have to die. So if you don't, like, you don't die, you can't do it. Bottom line, if you don't go die, you're not going to be the next Tupac, because it ain't going to be the next Tupac. Straight up.
Tough talk from a rapper paying millions for security a year.
Hell's the day you put out a hit, the day Diddy admits that he put the hit out, they got Pac killed, eh?
I think that last bar took it there with Puff. And I'm speculating here, but that was some shit.
Nothing to speculate about, nothing to talk about. Puff said it's in his hands, and he said, I can say it.
All right.
And that's the end of that.
Have fun with that one.
He said, you know, there's nothing to say about it. It's in my hands. He wild. Period.
Okay.
You fucking. Oh, and I'm just playing, Diddy. You know I love you.
Yo, YouTube. What up? It's your homie Gab. I'm in the building. And this is Machiavelli Media. Off the rip. Let me make this clear. I'm not a fan of Eminem's music. I never was, just not my cup of tea. But I must admit, out of all the rappers in the world, all these rappers that claim they got so much love for Tupac, some artists that knew him personally, some artists that came up underneath him, some artists that admired him from afar, none one of them has ever come forth and called P. Diddy out on the rumors and speculation that he may have been involved in Tupac's murder. Eminem is the only one. And it happened because he was mad at Diddy for backing Machine Gun Kelly, who was dissing the hell out of him. And some of, you know, Diddy's podcast shows said some unfavorable things about Eminem, but nevertheless, Eminem spoke the truth to the masses. So let's get into that for a minute. Because this has some severe ramifications to it. Like Eminem being petrified to come out of his house. Yeah, that's true. Now, let's keep in mind that Eminem has never been held to the same standards that most black rappers have been. Eminem never came from the hood. Came from the trailer park. The black rappers got to come from the hood. If they don't, they some kind of square, right? Eminem never sold drugs. Never said he did, right? Never had to rap about it. Most black rappers do. Or they're somehow like corny. They get put in the Will Smith category, right? I'm just speaking in general. Eminem never talks about busting his gun. He don't have to. Like 99.9% of all the black rappers. I'm just generalizing the obvious, right? And Eminem doesn't worry about being called a snitch like most black rappers would. They would never admit some of these guys are friends with Tupac and would never come out and say that they think or they knew that P. Diddy was involved in his murder. Eminem did. Came out and said it. He don't give a fuck about y'all standards. They don't apply to him, obviously. He lives in his own little bubble, and that's cool. He don't have to live up to your expectations. Because obviously, people supported him without going that route. So let's just get that out the way. But the beef started because Machine Gun Kelly said something about Eminem's daughter, Halle, and Eminem didn't like it. So he made a comment back, and then Machine Gun Kelly dissed him on Rap Devil. And then Eminem came back with Kill Shot, and he was mad at Puffy because Puffy manages Machine Gun Kelly, and he feel like because Puffy's relationship to Jimmy Iovine and him being so close and being a Jimmy Iovine artist, that Puffy should have never let one of his artists come at one of Jimmy's. So he got mad, and in Kill Shot, He told Machine Gun Kelly, the day you put out a hit, the day Diddy admits he put out the hit that got Tupac killed. Something like that. Don't quote me. Don't get mad. Once again, not an Eminem fan. But that fucked Diddy up. That fucked Diddy up. He was hot. Matter of fact, Joe Budden, you know, spoke on it and said that he talked to P. Diddy personally. And P. Diddy told him, I'm going to handle him. Now, what does that mean? That was 4 years ago. But just think back when Nick Cannon got into his verbal war with Eminem. Nick Cannon was saying in interviews on the radio station that they couldn't put hands on Eminem if they wanted to because he's never anywhere. They like, he's somewhere scared, hiding, back in the trailer parks or in his mansion, coked up or whatever they were saying. But they were saying the guy is scared to come outside. And I'm sure Nick Cannon would want to attribute that to himself, but I don't think he was scared of Nick Cannon. I think we all know why Eminem, if he is frightful, I think we all know who and why he might be feeling that way. It's just strange, man. You hear Jamie Foxx, you know the rumors. You heard what Jamie Foxx said about, you know, P. Diddy and his parties, and then, you know, Jamie fell a little under the weather. A lot of speculation that, you know, he was poisoned or what have you. We all know about Kim Porter. More speculation. And we all know what's going on with Keefe D right now. And we know what he said. And we know why Eminem said what he said. Eminem is a Tupac stan, a Tupac fanatic. He was writing letters to Miss Afeni Shakur, drawing pictures like, you know what I mean, freehanding like photos of Tupac sitting around his house. Sent them to Miss Afeni, and Miss Afeni was like, you know what? You want to do Tupac's album? You obviously love him. You know, Eminem was flattered that some people call him the white Tupac. I mean, the guy said he just a thug with a whole lot of Pac influence. Look how I got you dummies rocking to it. So he loves Tupac. So he probably couldn't wait to say what he said about P. Diddy in a song. In the song Kill Shot, Lord. I looked on YouTube before I did this video, and Killshot has over 470 views. That was just on one video. There's other channels that posted the song. There's other streaming services. No telling how many people heard him say that P. Diddy killed Tupac. I guarantee you, more people heard it come out of Eminem's mouth than they did it come out of Keefe D's mouth. Murder Rap was a, you know, a DVD, and then it was a book, and it got turned into like a series of some sorts, but I guarantee you, wasn't no 400 million nothing seeing all three of those publications combined. Eminem said it. Think about it. You ain't seen P. Diddy and Eminem in the same building since he made that statement. No American Music Awards. Nothing. And you won't. Because that is a stain on Puffy's name that he can't get rid of. And Eminem can never take back saying it. At the end of the song, I guess he thought about it, and sarcastically, he was like, you know, I'm just playing, Diddy. You know I love you. Tongue in cheek. Not meaning what he said, but still saying it just because he needed that buffer. You know, I didn't mean it. But you know what they say about a joke, right? Some truth to it. And just because it's funny don't mean it's not the truth. Or just because you say you was joking don't mean you ain't mean what you said. He meant it very well. And P. Diddy knows he meant it. In my opinion, Diddy had never let that go. And with the search warrant being issued recently for Keefe D, and Keefe D being under investigation, and, you know, his fate right now depending upon the verdict of a grand jury, I think Puffy's very nervous right about now. I called him his old name. I called him Puffy. Let me stick to P. Diddy so everybody know who I'm talking about. Some young cats in here like, who the fuck is Puffy? Now, everybody know who he is, but. And with that being said, I don't think this is over with. And I don't think Eminem is naive enough to think it's over with as well. I think he's going to continue to lay low and guard himself. And you hear Machine Gun Kelly say, Eminem paid for millions of dollars of security a year. I think he's going to continue that. And I think that's a smart move. Tell me what you think. Leave your thoughts in the comment section. Don't forget to sub to the channel. This is Machiavelli Media. Turn on the post notifications so you'll be the first ones to get it when I drop that shit. And oh yeah, I'm trying something different. Summer's almost over with. What I'm trying to do with some Tupac content, I'm trying to do it by this fall. So on Sundays only, I'm asking my subscribers to donate $1. Just $1. And that might help us get a little bit closer to our goals. Anyway, it's been a pleasure as always. I'm your homie Gab. I'm signing off. I'm about to hit y'all with the peace.